Would you like to start?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. So, thank you for joining tonight. This is like the strongest people who managed to come at night and still have energy to learn. That's great. So, my name is Dr. Larissa Miller. I'm from Melbourne. You can hear a typical Melbourne accent. So, and I'm originally from Russia, so I've been practicing cosmetics 100 years, since 2007. I was officially accredited cosmetologist, and then I came to Australia and practice here now, since 2013. So I'm medical doctor, I'm fellow of a couple of colleges, one of them ACM, Australasian College of Aesthetic Medicine. And today I wanted to discuss with you this interesting presentation called Biorevitalization. Did anyone know about that before? You heard, well, company of course know, but anyone else know about biorevitalization? That's actually very funny because this is the most commonly performed procedure in the offices in Russia, in Europe, in South Korea, in China now, very fast growing in United States. And the reason why? Because this is a procedure which very rarely give any complications, and it actually can address the most important part is the skin. So in a couple of words, that's what it does. We can work beautifully with a big muscle, with the big muscles by toxin, just relaxing by them. We can work beautifully by fillers or threads when we want to a little bit lift up or a little bit change contour. But what's about this very, very small wrinkles, this kind of dry, dehydrated skin? And I was actually just recently discussing with one of the beauticians, and she said, you can just have very nice cream and then it's absorbed. Well, I wish our skin absorbed. Unfortunately, our skin is not really that absorbing, because the whole idea of skin is what? Protection. And that's why whatever we put on the skin, no more than 5% absorb if you child and if you're lucky. So that's why whatever most beautiful cream in the world you've got, it only actually acts where? On the surface. That's why if you want to actually increase the whole quality of skin, you have to put something inside of the skin in a deepest basal layer where the most metabolic changes are happening. Alright? So that's why we use injections. So let's discuss first of all what's happening with us and why we need all these procedures in the first place. So for the aging in Australia, we're champions of the world, and for the aging, quite big problem here. And in fact, when I came here to Australia, I can't believe like this quality of skin which I saw here. And the main indication for this procedure is actually photo damaging. It's amazing results. The most amazing what you can do for photo damaged skin is biorevitalization. So as you all know, just a bit refresh, we have this dangerous UVB light, which actually damage our skin. Then skin have inflammation, and some patients see, but doctor, had sunburn only once. Yes, it's the ones which was bad enough, because inflammation is a spectrum. It can be to the degree of, like, you know, very big blisters, but it can be not even seen, but it's accumulating for years and years of being exposed to sun. And this kind of inflammatory stress, which actually destroy and age the skin a bit faster, especially in this wonderful sun in New South Wales and Queensland. So then when we have inflammation and dehydration of the skin, we, of course, our skin trying to consume as much moisturizer as it possibly can. And our natural moisturizer is what? Hyaluronic acid. That's why we have this drying out effect by the sun. Then it's not end of the story. It's also all these degradation products are being accumulated in the skin. And so quality of skin gradually decrease, and longer we have this process, longer this vicious circle is going. This because I explain more medical language, but how to explain it to patient? I just show this picture and say, look, when soil is dry, it really needs water. So now this is very, very depressing clinical research. When I saw it first time, I was like really, really sad, because basically what this Professor West in 1994 proven, that we can't live forever. Our DNA is actually have limited amount of doublings. So that's why instead of actually speeding up these doublings and using up resources, which limited resources which we're given, it's better to actually create the best and the safest environment for your skin, so it will not be stressed and damaged in the first place. Because what we use now, like you have a patient who has photo-damaged skin, a bit of wrinkles, you offer maybe peeling. If you like to have laser or RF, you offer this then. But it doesn't really matter what you do. It's still the same mechanism. It's controlled damage of the skin. And then you expect skin to regenerate, right? And that's fair enough. And it is. But unfortunately, we have only from 50 to 100 doublings. So we pretty much buy in a short-term use with a long-term price. So that's, I'm not saying this is bad. It's just everything in moderation, and that's why just keep damaging already damaged skin, probably not the best long-term strategy. Like I explained to my patients, look, you're sick, you're damaged, you're just unwell, and then you decided, now I want to be healthy, now I want to look good, and I will go to gym. And you go to gym, do you think when you're sick and you go to gym, you actually will be healthy? Not really. What you have to do first, you have to provide yourself with a fantastic nutrition. You have to make yourself, actually, your body to recover, and then you go to gym. And skin is the same as our rest of our body. That's why if you just first provide a fantastic nutrition and a good regeneration capacity to your skin, and then damage, that combination will work actually much better and much safer as well. So what is collagen? Everyone knows probably in this room. So this is like a main gold which we'll want in our skin. This is like a building bricks which actually make this beautiful architecture. Like you can see how this columns actually holding our skin nice. And when we're young, we don't have wrinkles because our skin is so thick and firm. And then collagen with age become like wear and tear, and that's why we have a bit of more wrinkly appearance. So this is another slide for skin aging, that skin aging is not just the wrinkles. Because patients come to us, like, oh, I have this wrinkle. But if you educate them, look, skin is not just wrinkle, it's also the structure of the skin, the thickness of the skin, the pigment accumulated, the fat compartments are different. This is all together giving you an idea. So skin aging clinically, obviously we have loss of luminosity, like I said to my patients, accumulation of products, of degradation, and that's why it's like murky water, we just have to clear this out. Dark areas, fine lines, I'm sure you know. So, and what is biorevitalization? This is placing natural moisturizer, hyaluronic acid, exactly in the area of skin where it's supposed to be. Plus, it's also microtraumas. When I will be doing procedure, you can see that I actually do like a microneedling. And so these two mechanisms together give a synergy effect by making the lift up and also giving fantastic nutrition for the skin to regenerate naturally. So a mechanism that hyaluronic acid triggers circulation process, it's actually quite funny moment. You will see that when I inject, like just around this area, it will be a bit of redness. And it looks like it's allergic reaction, but it's not. It's actually because hyaluronic acid start microcirculation, start local metabolism, and actually attract kind of local healing process. That's why you see this redness. This is the, oops, a little bit too far. Now you saw whole presentation. Okay, go home. So, start this circulation process and provide moisture and nutrition for the skin. So you don't just have a good environment for regeneration, but also you provide the bricks which it will be building. So, and after the tissue is saturated, hyaluronic acid stimulates the synthesis of collagen and elastin, which is like a natural consequences of giving our body nice opportunity. Like this beautiful principle of medicine, when you stop harming body heals itself. So you just give your body the best condition and it heals itself. So advantages for the patient, natural and organic, as you know, non-cross-linked hyaluronic acid, it's pretty much organic, it's exactly how we have in our body. And usually older we are, less hyaluronic acid we have everywhere, in our joints, in our skin, in our eyes, everywhere. And that's why, if you probably know, besides cosmetic medicine use, we use exactly the same product for injecting into eyes, injecting into joints. So it's pretty much everywhere in the body the same process. And this is natural organic hyaluronic acid. It's very low trauma, that's why small downtime, like usually it's lunchtime procedure or next day they go to work. A very low chance of complication because you're staying within the skin, and I will show you my needle, it's like 4 millimeters. It's very, very small. Even if you're drunk, you can't harm the patient. It's just too small. Obviously, you can actually work within danger areas as well because it's very superficial. That's why you can't really cause granulomas or embolism or any other dangerous complications. No job overdone effect. Luminosity of the skin, as I said, like one of my favorite ones that's actually slowed down aging because it's actually healing the skin. So basically it's a combination between the injectable filler and mesotherapy. So who's the ideal patient? Do you think it will be an ideal one? His name is Victor, he's living in Monash University. Very long waiting list, as you can see, to see doctors there. But someone who is actually like that, who's actually have very, very dry skin, they will be perfect patient. So indications, endless. This, as I mentioned, the most common procedure in Eastern Europe and Russia and Korea, because it just makes skin regenerate. But if you will ask me in research what was the number one effect, which patients and doctors were talking about, that would be luminosity of the skin. This is the first thing which they notice. It's like from inside our skin become like a lightening. So indications again, quite a few. Contraindications, it's not much. It's a typical like any other injections. Pregnancy and lactation, just because it's unethical, we don't know. Autoimmune disorder, just because it's injection and which stimulate process. That's why if they have some subclinical lupus or something, it can actually be stimulated as well. Local skin infections, especially people with recurrent herpes, I usually give them Valtrex 3 days before, just in case. Acute infection, like any other injectable treatment. Allergy to hyaluronic acid, theoretically it exists, but nobody saw it. So what are techniques, the main techniques which you can use with a Princess Rich or non-crosslink hyaluronic acid? When you just start, one of the best and safest one would be napage. Napage from French means like a blanket coverage, so which is like multiple injections, very superficial. Some dermal clinicians use Princess Rich with Dermapen. It's napage technique, very, very safe, hard to get wrong. Why I personally don't do this in my clinic, because the product is expensive and you just lose too much on the top. So if I want to utilize all product I get in the best capacity. And that's why the most commonly used is actually intradermal papule. It's even for beginner, as soon as you registered nurse or doctor, it's quite safe to use. And then when you will be familiar with this technique, you can go to like advanced liner technique. That's awesome. Very, very beautiful results, but obviously you have to familiarize yourself first with a safer papule technique. Here we go. So this is napage. Some people use machines. I bought machine, like a gun they call it, at some stage. I found that it's not as useful for my personal, because by hands I do this much quicker. But if you're not familiar, why not? It's quite predictable. Basically just multiple injections, very superficially. This is papule technique, this is the most common one. Patients call it mosquito bites. So this is how it looks like, and you just place the filler very, very superficially. You can actually see this white thing, and this is actually quite a cool thing, because by the appearance of papules, you can say how much is the dehydration. When I came to Australia, this is the first time in my life, when I inject hyaluronic acid and it disappears straight away, it's like, wow, that's amazing. So it's a photo-damaged skin. It's so hungry for moisturizer, it's so dry that it straight away absorbed. In Russia, we usually say it's like we have no sun at all. So it's like 3 days, maybe up to 3 days, if you use it correct. And this is one of my favorites. It's a linear technique. It's like a micro threads, but it's very tricky because it must be within the skin, not under the skin like you do with a filler or threads, but actually inside the skin. So it's not a cannula because cannula is too blunt. It can't actually penetrate the skin. So you use a very long needle, usually very thin, like 32 gauge or 30 gauge, and you just like a butcher, knife and a butcher go inside of the skin in a projection of the Langer's line, you know, with a maximum of collagen production. And one of the most popular are these ones because it gives you lifting like that, so very popular. But I would not advise you to start with this technique, just make like yourself familiar with the most simple and safe one, and when you feel you actually get this skill, upgrade yourself, preferably after training. This is the most common areas where it's used. So not much materials. This is a mesa needle. Everything else is pretty much what you have already in your practice. Gun, as I mentioned, I just don't use because I found manual is much quicker and I don't use as much product. So this is a Langer's line. Like anyone who's doing surgery knows them very well. This is, if you stretch the skin in all directions, in some direction they stretch better. And this is because in some lines, our collagen fibroblasts work with production of the collagen better. And that's why if you do across these lines, that will be giving you more collagen stimulation. You probably know about Langer, right? Anyone heard? Yeah, good. This is the first thing they told you when you start skin cancer. So this is a protocol which was in Italy in 2015. It was published a study. In Italy, they don't have much photo damage in comparison to Australia, and that's probably here will be a little bit more needed. But this is what we have researched at the moment. So it's a 3 treatments, 3 weeks apart. You know why? Because when you inject, besides immediate moisturizing effect, which they see straight away, you just start the process of collagen production and it's growing, growing, and then after 3 weeks, it's actually maximum, and then it's supposed to slow down. But you don't let it slow down, you catch it on the maximum and boost it again, so you have a little bit of more, and then do the third time. And after 3 procedures, you can actually see a very good effect. And when we consent the patient, we explain that, look, after first procedure, you can see only moisturizer, but the maximum effect will be 3 weeks after third procedure. All right. So some tips when you do, make sure bagel is up, not down, because what is below the skin is fat. So you just sink it, it's like storage. So it's a waste of product because it's not cross-linked. But if you go up, it means that you pretty much moisturize the skin. When you go into skin, like orbital area, where there's a very thin skin, make sure that you have very small papules, because thin skin means that it will take a bit longer for your body to actually clear these papules, and you don't want your patient to have these mosquito bites like all over the face. So just in a thinner skin, smaller papules. In a thicker, like décolletage, a bit more like 3 millimeters, 4 millimeters. So yeah, when disappear, again, this is more for like overseas where we have no sun. In Australia, most of my patients, by the end of procedure, they don't have, or next morning, they don't have any anything seen. This is what I was mentioning about. Can you see this redness? It looks like urticaria reaction. It's actually great. When you see this, it's, yes, it's fantastic news. It means collagen will be working. So this is one of the protocols which is used. Cosmetics, it's all about budget, isn't it? We don't have multimillionaires who come into us with limitless budget. That's why the first question I usually ask, like, look, what you can do today? If patient will say, whatever you can, I usually suggest all exposed area to the sun, which is face, neck, and hands. Because if it's all organically together, rejuvenated, it's actually beautiful, isn't it? But when women have like only up to the neck beautiful skin and then everything else is old, it's not that great look. That's why it's better to actually consent the patient to do whole look. But most of the patients, they maybe can afford only one meal, and that's why you just focus on most problematic areas of this patient. I personally don't attach to these protocols because it's all about what is a bother of the patient and how we can help them the most. Aftercare advice, nothing really specific, just avoid direct sauna or exposure to sun for a few days. Sometimes I clean with hydroxy peroxide, but I actually like hyaluronic acid mask because once you have all this microneedle effect and the channels open and then you have a mask on the top, it's actually a boost effect and it calms down patient. They usually fall asleep. And it's just pleasant, why not? And after 2 hours, they can apply some anti-stress mask at home, for example. So this is a patient handout. If you like, feel free to make a picture. So nothing really specific. It's very similar to what you've got for your fillers and toxins. Okay. So this is a just quite commonly heard question because some of the patients say, why? How, what can I do to make my filler stay longer? And it was some research done that grapeseed oil extract actually inhibits hyaluronidase. And it's also antioxidant. And just to make a patient feel better, and if they ask, I can advise. But in my practice, I didn't see the big difference, being honest. So, but just if patient ask, that's what we can advise. This is a lovely lady after 3 procedures. So it's generally, it's not feeling. It's just a kind of this micro small wrinkly look, and also it's usually given a lightening. So this is just immediately after procedure. Actually, if your patient is under budget and they have only one meal, this is area which give you quite a lot of satisfaction because it give it lift up your lateral corner of the eye, and it's always look good. And also this kind of glowing masterizing look in this area usually perceived as a beauty, and it's such a small amount of filler you need there. This is some patient examples. As you can see, like besides the wrinkle, the most important is kind of glowing. That's what they usually that's what usually patient will tell to you, I can see it's glowing. It's another patient. This is like it's a male. He wanted his hands particularly to be done. Well, she's done quite a few things. I actually like combination of treatment. I truly believe beauty is a combination. It's like I explain to my patients: if you have old car and you have fantastic shiny new wheels, it will look weird. But if you will actually all together make your car a bit more in harmony, that actually will give you quite a nice look. And then the same with beauty. If you have fantastic skin, but everything else is not really like up to the point, you know, it's better to have a little bit of toxin. Like for this patient, we did, as you can see, toxin here and a bit of filler in this area in the lips and body utilization. She was quite happy. This is a very tricky patient because she was Fitzpatrick 4, and I was really afraid of hyperpigmentation risk. And we did a bit of hydroquinone, mandelic acid peel before, and then oral supplementation is vitamin C. Probably some of you know that vitamin C, very mild inhibitor of melanocytes. So that's all together in combination. You know, like vitamin C give us 10% effect, hydroquinone, and all together we get to a quite nice prevention of the risk of hyperpigmentation. And she was very happy actually with the result. It also helped you see these acne scars for her and this chronic inflammation. This lovely lady spent a lot of time in the beach. So, and when she came, I was like, wow, I can't believe that it was so, her skin was just absorbing the hyaluronic acid. It was so hungry, so dry, but she was very happy with the results. And voila! So thank you so much for your attention. Now, probably if you'd like,